Let's do a quick exercise and we'll try to build a nice example in Excel. Okay, and now we have this chart that I have shown. So the chart with the variances, right? But of course, you have more requirements. You want to see this data either as month-to-date data or even year-to-date. Okay, so that's why I have this switch here to switch between month-to-date and year-to-date. Okay, so what do you need for that? You need your data. You need Zero BI charts visual and a couple of ideas and a couple of Excel tips and tricks to build this. This is my data. Now, if I just visualize this data, I already have the chart. I already have the chart here, but I don't have the switch. So how did I get this switch here? What is this element in Excel? So this is a native Excel element. It's simply a slicer, okay? But to insert a slicer, so you have several ways how to insert slicers. In my case, we will do a small trick with a pivot table. So let me just type this in. So I will create a switch for my period calculation. This switch has a value of month to date and year to date. Okay. And now I will select this. Okay. And I will insert a pivot table. I'll insert a pivot table and just insert it here. All right. Okay. So pivot table, let's show the field list. Why am I doing this? I only have this one field because I just have one column with two values, right? So I'll move this to the filter area in a pivot table, okay? This is just a simple trick to make sure that I have this switch, okay, from month to date to year to date, okay? So, but it looks like a regular pivot table filter. Okay, now we'll use this field. So I can simply right click or no, let's go to insert. And now I will use this field to create the slicer in Excel. So I will use the period calculation slicer. And now my slicer already flips this value from month to date to year to date. But of course, now I need to do a couple of more things, right? This data is still my static data, my monthly data. So I need to enter a couple of formulas to make sure to read this switch and then return either month to date or year to date values. Okay, so first of all, let's move this slicer up. You can actually design the slicer. For example, how to make the slicer horizontal in Excel. Just increase the number of columns. In my case, I'm just going to have two values always. So I will display my elements in the slicer in two columns, and that's it. So this now works as expected. Why is this shifting left and right? Because this is a pivot table that by default will always set the column width automatically. So for this, you need to check a few or uncheck rather a couple of options here. So this one, auto fit column widths on update. This is the switch, the checkbox that you need to remove. Okay, now this column will stay fixed here. Okay, so this is now working, but now I have some more work to do. So first of all, I will now create a second table. Okay, this is my month and this is January. So this will stay the same. So let me just move it down, December. All right, exactly like this. My So this will be my new table, right? This will be my new table that will take into account the switch that I have placed here, the value here. So instead of just linking this value here, I will actually say if this value here, okay, and it's already called period calculation. Why is it called period calculation? Because I've done this before at home. So I just named it period calculation, okay? So just click on the cell and you give it a name in Excel, okay? And now you can refer to this name in the formulas. So this is going to be easier now. So let's say if my period, or just click on it, if my period calculation equals month to date. So if this is month to date, I'll simply return the value from the above table. If not, I need to calculate the year to date value, and the year to date value will be sum of this, almost like this, but what I need to sum the values from the first cell, so this the cell in row number 7 to the current cell, which means that I need to fix my formula here. So I'll just fix the column, fix the row. That's why the dollar sign here. So I pressed F4 two times. Okay, and this is it. And I need the closing parenthesis here. Okay. So these are now my previous year's values. So they are the same as above, because I have month to date here. But now when I click here, the value has changed and my formula is now actually returning this second part. The sum, which is actually accumulated value or year to date value. All right, and now I simply copy those values here. And we can fix this, I guess, later. Also, we need to link the comments, make sure that the comments are also down. So now if you'll simply use equal sign, you'll have a problem because Excel will return zero. So it's better that you actually check. So if you check if the cell is blank, so this is what is blank formula will do. So you check if this is blank. All right, so if this is blank, like this, then what? Then we'll return an empty string like this. Otherwise, we'll actually return the text of the comments. So either an empty text or the actual text of the comments. This is just to make sure that you don't have zeros here. Okay, and now what we will do, we'll simply delete this chart here and use this table as the source for the Zebra BI visuals to make sure that we visualize this properly. Move it up. Okay, let's check the columns. All right, you already see that this is now year-to-date values. It's growing each month. And my switch now works. Okay. In reality, then it's even better that you check for empty values also in the actual column, so that you don't have the same year to date value here. So you would need another is blank formula to check if this formula is blank or not, and if it is blank, just return the blank value. Okay, so this is just a quick demonstration how you can now combine Excel features to create reports that are, you know, fully interactive just by using formulas. So this is also a nice view of year-to-date values. Okay, so with a couple of formulas and tricks, you create interactive reports that you can then share with your viewers.